capturing labels, so let me recapture the label. There's a transfer working group that the NCA has appointed. Ross Bjork at Ole Miss is a member of that transfer working group. They identified some changes to the current transfer policy, three in particular, which is that school A, somebody decides to leave a school from school A to school B, school A shouldn't control communication, destination, or financial aid if somebody decides to transfer. I think those are entirely appropriate conversations. Now, the next level is, how do you deal with the idea of 365-day a year recruiting? I think young people have to be sensitive to that. We talked about that issue with our student athletes this week. Right now, it's a feedback, circumstance feedback opportunity. I think it's a very healthy conversation. I think some of those changes should occur. I'm also attentive to the idea of year residence. You know, we know from research, I don't have all the numbers, that when you transfer, your time to graduation is extended. So what educational basis is there to make your residency maybe even more standard, and how does that guide some decision making? Those are important conversations. I'm glad they're happening, and we'll see what the outcome is. That's why I captured a little bit differently than just kind of free agency. In addition, it puts a lot of expectation on making sure young people have a really good experience if you do make those changes, so that they want to be and represent the university where they're enrolled.
Next question, left side of the back.
Hey, Commissioner, Justin Thomas with Fox 6 here in Birmingham. Could you talk about the 14-week season in depth for those of us that wasn't in there when you were explaining it?
Yeah, one of the things I've learned is just because I said it in another room doesn't mean that everybody heard that, so thank you for that reminder. The 14-week season conversation has been around for a while, and to be very clear, it's 12 games with two open weeks within those 14 weeks. Then the conference championship came. The NCAA Football Oversight Committee asked this spring for conferences to provide feedback on some concepts. A couple points from us. One, we're interested in that. That potential additional open week might be a healthy change. However, we don't want to see preseason practice begin any earlier than it has been. In fact, this year we were supportive of the health and safety changes that were adopted, but it allows practice to start a week earlier. Most of our programs are not accessing that week. They also want to continue to have access to 29 preseason practice opportunities. Not that everyone uses all of those opportunities, but there may be dynamics that put a program in a situation where they need more practice in preparation for that first game. So we're interested, we're curious, we're supportive of the dialogue, but want to figure out what do we do with the bookends that we have, because 14-week seasons happen every two, three, four years on an ad hoc basis based on the spacing of the calendar. And the issue will be, can we make that happen on a regular basis?
Thank you.
Next question, left side.
Christopher Walsh, SEC Country. Does the SEC have a stance or a position on the California law that doesn't allow state sponsor travel into states like Alabama now and Kentucky? And would the SEC consider a conference ban on traveling to California for events?
Two questions. They're both related to the same issue. We've not had a discussion about California state laws within the context of the Southeastern Conference meetings. So I think that probably answers part A and part B, I hope,
Christopher. Greg, can you kind of go more in depth into the six-person committee on recruiting and with the two athletic directors and the four coaches, what dialogue you're trying to get accomplished, and B, why there wasn't a student athlete put on this committee, since it kind of involved them as well?
We appointed that after our Destin meetings. And we've also used our student-athlete meetings to talk fully with that group about recruiting, which is a different conversation, you might imagine. One of the reasons to appoint a football leadership council is to engage a football student-athlete, highly recruited, scholarship, playing time person, in exactly those conversations. So we think we've addressed that and through a different vehicle, and it provides input into that, this working group. really is to say that we have concerns about the recruiting package that was adopted, and you've probably heard or read of those concerns from our football coaches. So rather than just let those concerns exist, let's identify what it is we want from a recruiting standpoint. One. Two, let's look at the changes that have been made and discuss internally how are those working. What does it mean practically? What are summer camps really like? You need coaches involved in that activity because it's real-time information. And those were the drivers, both preparing for input that might be provided to provide some analysis of what's happening now, and then further conversation for points of input like our student athlete leadership council in football.
We have time for about two more questions. Back row on the left.
Some schools outside the SEC have had real success with opt-in systems. Have you considered changing the rule in the SEC to allow that?
We've not considered changing the rule. It's been a discussion item. I acknowledge that in Destin. We still maintain the same rule, and we'll work with our schools to make sure that the policy expectations are met. And I'm quite confident it will be an ongoing topic of conversation. I wouldn't just describe what's happened in other venues that are only successful, though. So that it has been implemented, and we're aware of that. We'll be monitoring that, trying to learn from those experiences a bit.
Last question, still left side, third row.
Can you talk about your feelings on the opening week with the SEC playing ACC to open up the new facility, two games down in Atlanta?
I think we've seen, starting last year, when we added that ninth game requirement being against the colleague conferences, a set of great opening weeks. Now, last year was a good start to the season from an awareness standpoint. We had good competitive success in 16. We look forward to, as you mentioned, Mercedes-Benz Stadium. We'll see it twice, Florida State-Alabama game, Georgia Tech-Tennessee. That's a good experience for our teams and the focus around those games. But then you've got LSU and BYU and Houston, Florida and Michigan and Dallas. Texas A&M's out in LA playing UCLA, North Carolina State and South Carolina and Charlotte, and kind of those unique games, unique venues. And then there are other non-conference games. We've got Georgia and Notre Dame in September. We've got Arkansas and TCU, and I could go on, but I haven't memorized all of those. Kansas State comes to Nashville. This is when people tell me don't do this because you get in trouble. Auburn's in Clemson, right? That's this year. And Purdue's in Missouri. Who did I miss? Really about anyone?
In the season rivalries.
Pretty good.
Florida State, Florida.
Yeah, those as well. But, you know, it's a great kind of wave of momentum into the season, to answer your question directly. And certainly being on the new platform